As we introduce these different properties, you want to keep in mind that what the derivative always tells us about is the rate of change of our function at some specific point. So for some arbitrary function that we'll draw here. So if this is our function f of x, once we find the derivative of that function, then we can plug in any value of x, say x equals a, and get the rate of change of our function at that specific point. If we can get the rate of change of the function at that point, that means we're finding the slope of the tangent line. So there's some linear function, something of the form y equals mx plus b, that describes that tangent line, where m is the rate of change and b is the intercept for that linear function. So using the techniques we've established so far in this section, we want to find the derivative of this function, find the slope at a given point, and then the equation of the tangent line. So first we want to find f prime of x. So using the techniques we've already looked at, we can look at just differentiating this term by term. So the derivative of 2x to the fourth will become 8x to the third minus 24x cubed. Taking the derivative of that will give us 3 times 24, which is 72x squared, once we reduce that exponent by 1. And then the derivative of 6 is just 0. So our derivative is 8x cubed minus 72x squared. We then want to find the slope of the graph, or the rate of change of our graph, at x equals 1, which means we want to evaluate f prime of 1, which in this case would be 8 times 1 cubed, which is 1, minus 72 times 1 squared, which is 1, or negative 64. So again, keep in mind what that's giving us is the slope m for that equation in slope-intercept form, the equation for our tangent line. So now that we know this slope, we want to find the equation of the tangent line at x equals 1. So what we know already is the slope, so we know that y equals negative 64x plus some intercept b. So then what we can do is plug in values for x and y. In this point, we're considering what's happening at the point x equals 1. So our value for x should be x equals 1, which means our y value will be the original function evaluated at 1, which in this case is negative 16. So we would come back to the original function and evaluate f of 1 to get that negative 16. So this means we'll get negative 16 equals 64 times 1 plus that value for b that we're still trying to find. Or I'm sorry, that should be negative 64 times 1. So if we add the 64 to both sides, we'll get 48 equals b, which gives us the equation for our tangent line of y equals negative 64x plus 48. So once we have the slope, we can look at whatever point we're considering, in this case at x equals 1, find the function value at 1, and solve for that remaining unknown. The other question we want to answer here is we want to find any values of x where the tangent line is horizontal. So I'm not going to sketch the function that we're actually looking at here, but just to kind of look at an arbitrary function so we can see what behavior we're trying to identify here. So for some given function, we could look at it and say that it's increasing on some interval, and then at some point changes to decreasing. So there's some point, just for an instant, where that rate of change is zero. And the same thing would happen if this changes from decreasing to increasing. So there's some point, just for an instant, where that rate of change is zero as it changes from a negative slope to a positive slope. So to find those, where our tangent line is horizontal, means we want to find where is the rate of change equal to 0. So we want to take our derivative function and set it equal to 0, meaning 8x cubed minus 72x squared needs to be set equal to 0. We can factor out an 8x squared, leaving us with x minus 9. And then solving for x gives us two different values. So at x equals 0 and x equals 9, our behavior, our function has this point where, just for an instant, that tangent line becomes horizontal. So the rate of change becomes 0 just for that moment.